Well, a study out this week found that COVID-19 pandemic may have been 3 times deadlier than the current death toll suggests. Joining us to answer your questions is Dr. Sandra Nelson, an infectious disease specialist at Mass General. Dr. Nelson, thanks for being here. We're 2 years into the pandemic now and hopefully on our way out. As we say good morning, we really want to know, how important is it to get this figure right?
Now, this has really been for many of us a week of reflection as we've paused to think about the impact that this pandemic has had on our collective experience. You know, this study estimated that 18 million individuals worldwide have died, you know, and that's just a staggering number. But I think getting the number right is more about just the, it's more than just knowing how many people have died. It's about where they are. Where are the individuals who are most affected by this? Because that helps us to target public health resources to those that are most impacted.
Health equity, very important, yes. And starting Monday, Brown University will not require students to get regularly tested for COVID, something that's been a staple for the last year or more. Are we gonna see more testing requirements dropped, and is that a good idea?
You know, now that we have effective vaccines and treatments that prevent severe disease, I think we are moving away from a goal of identifying and isolating all individuals who are affected to learning that we can really live with this virus. And I think as long as we're talking about healthy and highly vaccinated populations, abandoning these screening testing programs right now makes sense. You know, but I think there may be times in the future when the rates go up or we're dealing with more severe variants. And so I don't think it's time to completely dismantle that testing infrastructure.
Okay, I still have my kids at home too. And big events are really starting to return. Next weekend, South Boston hosts its annual St. Patrick's Day parade for the first time in 2 years. What should people be thinking about as they go back out to gatherings, large ones like this one, in large numbers?
Well, you know, right now, all of the metrics are looking great in the area. We have very few cases. We have very few hospitalizations. The wastewater data looks really good. And I think as a society, we really need to learn to take advantage of these times, because there may be times in the future when the disease rates go up or we're dealing with more severe variants and we can't be so carefree. And so I think right now, large gatherings for most people are really quite safe and we should really get out and enjoy them. But that's not the same as saying that they're no risk. And there are going to be some individuals who, for their own risk or for the risk of those in their family, may choose not to attend or to at least mask while they do attend these gatherings.
Okay, and to that end, just 2% of Americans now live in a county where the CDC would recommend universal indoor masking. But even some top scientists are careful to say we're not out of this pandemic just yet. What are you watching for when it comes to declaring it would be over?
You know, I think it's important to acknowledge that the CDC also recently changed its definition of risk. The CDC is now accepting some level of disease as being acceptable as long as we have effective treatments and as long as the healthcare infrastructure is not really jeopardized by this. But this is a pretty fundamental change. It doesn't mean that the pandemic is over. As long as there remain the ability of in parts of the world where there's less vaccination to really sprout these new variants, we're going to continue to see outbreaks on our own soil. You know, you asked me about the excess deaths at the beginning of this segment, and I think really until we see those excess deaths in that negligible range, we just cannot declare victory over this virus.
Okay, thank you so much. Dr. Sandra Nelson, an infectious disease specialist at Mass General Hospital. Good morning to your dog there, too. Thanks for joining
us. Sorry about that. Thanks so much.
Not a problem.